Heritage of Faith. We're so glad that you're here today. We believe that you're going to experience the presence of God and the love of God like you never have before.
And we believe today your life will be radically transformed because of the Word of God that will come forth this morning. We also believe that when you leave this place today, you will influence someone else's life. We're so grateful that you're here at Heritage of Faith.
Chariots of Light Biker Club is giving you the opportunity to make a difference in your world. Join our HFCC chapter for our monthly meetings, followed by a weekend ride. Skateboarding, music, popcorn, that's right, youth group. Come join us in G29 on Wednesdays and Sunday nights as we hang out with friends and hear a powerful word from God for our lives. There will be no Thrive groups this month because of Father's Day. We'll see you back in July. Are you hungry for more of God? Come to our next night of worship on June 12th. With no agenda of our own, we simply pursue God. Heritage Kids Going to Discovery Camp will have three fundraisers this month, including Sonic, Sweet Frogs, and a dessert auction. Pick up a flyer in the lobby for more information or go to our website at heritageoffaith.com. If you're a first-time visitor, we would love to meet you. Stop by and see us after service for a special gift. Thank you for joining us today.
So let's stand up on our feet and let us worship God together and see what amazing change takes place in our life today.
Good morning, everyone. Are we ready? Yes.
Bursting, bursting, the
break open prison doors. Set all the captives free. Spring up a well, spring up a well, spring up a well. and it covers us. It covers us from head to toe. Yeah. It covers you from head to toe. You're covered. You're covered by His love. Oh. His love covers you from head to toe. Here on the inside of me, you need to let your kids go. You need to loosen the grip, loosen the control grip, because Abba Daddy has them. He's heard your prayer. It's tough for me to speak this because I haven't been in this situation before, but I'm just going to be bold, okay? And know this is with the love of the Father. But you got to let go, because He can't move until you get out of the way. Amen? He's got him. He's got him. He's heard your prayers. He's heard him. Amen? So just let him take him. And you watch. You watch. They will serve the Lord. Amen? Because His love is going to be what overtakes them. Amen? Amen. So we receive that, Father. We receive that. We receive that love is pouring out over these children and children's children, grandchildren. They're coming in Jesus' name. They're coming in. It's time. It's the harvest time. We pull them in with our faith. We release them as we release our faith. We thank you, Father. We receive it. We receive it. We receive it. We bless you, Lord, for it. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord.
Holy Spirit, you always. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. You know, we've been talking about pour it out. You know, and Joel prophesies, says, I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. He talks about sons and daughters prophesying. He talks about different people seeing visions and seeing people's dreams. And then he goes in and talks about that I will pour out my spirit on my servants and my handmaidens. And it says they shall prophesy. And you know, if we look at that word in a religious text of the word prophecy, meaning I'm giving a direct word to someone or to a certain people, that's not what this word means. The word prophecy, actually, what Joel declares it in the Hebrew, it actually means to speak forth abundantly. It also means to break forth into praise. It also talks about speaking and singing inspirational songs. So when he talks about, I will pour out my spirit and my handmaidens and my servants will prophesy, it's not that they're just going to read someone's mail, but it's saying out of them, because the Spirit of God is on the inside of them, out of them will be released prophetic worship. Out of them will be released worship. Out of them will be released divine inspiration, and they will bubble forth and they will break forth into praise. That's what that word prophesy means. So when he talks about pouring out his spirit, and it says what's going to be the response of being filled with his spirit, is going to be a response to his goodness. It's going to be talking about how amazing he is, about how wonderful he is. See, when they were filled with the Holy Spirit, what did everyone say around them? It said, we hear them talking in our dialect. We hear them talking in their language, but they're Galileans. They're Jews. They don't know our language. So what are they saying? It says that we hear them talking and declaring what? The goodness of God. So when we talk about His Spirit being poured out on us, it's talking about something happening on the inside of you where you're releasing praise. You're releasing your worship. You're releasing words that are divine inspiration. Hallelujah. Father, we just thank you, Lord, for your goodness in this place. We thank you, Holy Spirit, for being in this place. Holy Spirit, we thank you for ruling and reigning in this place. We thank you for having your way in this place today. Holy Spirit, you're welcome here. Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place. This is the year of the great breaking loose. More and more signs and wonders. More and more healings. More and more finances breaking loose. More and more notable miracles. More and more. More and more. Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place to manifest the Word of God and the will of God in our presence, in our midst. That we would not leave this place the way that we came. But we'd be changed in your presence. Changed by your presence. Changed by your word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place. You're welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place. To move in this place. To move in every up and down every single row, in and out of every aisle, you will be working throughout this entire service. Hallelujah. A great breaking loose. Great breaking loose. I thank you, Father, for suddenlies taking place right now. Suddenlies happening in this place. Suddenlies manifesting in this place. Hallelujah. A great breaking loose. A great breaking loose. A great breaking loose. Oh, instant healings. Hallelujah. 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 Just start to do something maybe you weren't able to do before. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place. Oh, we thank you for it, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, we release our thanksgiving. We release our worship. We release our praise to you, Father. Hallelujah. You're welcome in this place. Hallelujah. You're welcome in this place. Hallelujah. You're welcome in this place. Hallelujah. To remove every restraint, every barrier. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for it. We praise you for it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You can go ahead and be seated. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm going to get right into the Word. If you have your Bibles, turn to Isaiah 59. Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit is in this place. Hallelujah. Say that with me. The Holy Spirit is in this place. Jesus, the Holy Spirit, and Father God respond to faith. They respond to faith. We know, and I learned this from Dr. Savelle a long time ago, that God doesn't move where He is needed.
That's right.
He moves where He is sought. Come on. And so I want to ask you a question. What place are you giving Him in your life? What position are you giving Him in your life? What role does He have when it comes to your finances? What role does He have when it comes to your marriage? What role does He have? Because whatever role that you give Him is the area that He's able to access. Proverbs tells us, he says, in all your ways acknowledge Him and He will direct your path. Meaning, if I don't acknowledge Him, He can't direct my path. So there's an exchange that takes place, and it is our worship, it is our pursuit, and as we pursue Him, He manifests Himself.
Amen. That's right.
That's how He works. That's how He moves. That's how His Word works. And we've been talking about pour it out.
Come on.
Say pour it out.
Pour it out.
Say pour it out. See, He desires to pour out His Spirit on all flesh.
Yes. Come on.
Joel prophesied it. Yeah. Isaiah declared it. John the Baptist was waiting for the one that was going to bring it. That's and right. Jesus told the disciples, go to Jerusalem and don't leave there until you get it.
Come on. That's right.
Jesus said, it's expedient that I go away because if I don't go away, the Comforter cannot come.
Yeah.
If I don't leave here, the one that you need can't come. I know you appreciate me. I know that you're glad that I'm here. And I know that you find great things by following me, but there's something else that you need. And it was the Holy Spirit. He said, go wait in Jerusalem until you be clothed with power from on high. The Holy Spirit, I want you to know, is a big deal. The Holy Spirit is a big deal. Say a big deal. He is not a message. He's not a side issue. Matter of fact, if you don't understand the Holy Spirit, it will be hard for you to ever to walk in and understand the love of God or the grace of God. Because if you don't understand the Holy Spirit, the Bible says the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by what? The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is a spirit of what? A spirit of grace. So there's a lot of people exalting different messages and different things, but I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit isn't being talked about enough.
Come on.
The Holy Spirit isn't being talked about enough. The Holy Spirit is so important for the Holy Spirit. Jesus spent 4 chapters talking to the disciples about what they needed for success in the future. And it all stemmed around the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, the Standby. And this is probably about the 6th week I've talked on this. If you haven't been here, I would encourage you to go to our website, pull up those messages, listen to them, because I don't have time to go back and lay the foundation for who the Holy Spirit is and what He does. But the Holy Spirit, Jesus, it said, That he, it said that how God anointed him with Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good and healing all, healing all, healing all that were oppressed of the devil. It didn't say that Jesus went about just healing all. It said how God anointed him with two things, the Holy Ghost and power. And it really is just one thing, the Holy Ghost and power. The Holy Ghost is equivalent to power. Holy Ghost and power. And because he had the Holy Ghost and power, he was able to go about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil. Oppression, oppressed. The word oppressed means to be burdened down with cruel restraints. It means to lay a heavy burden upon. So Jesus went about freeing people that were burdened down by heavy things. Jesus went about ministering to those, healing those, and setting free those that were burdened down because of cruel restraints. Oppression is not the work of God. It is the work of Satan.
Come on. That's right.
Oppression is not God's way of testing you.
Come on.
Oppression is not God's way of seeing what's on the inside of you. Oppression is the enemy's way to defeat you, to control you. It's the enemy's tactics to keep you from ever possessing who you were always created to be. And oppression can come in many forms. Oppression can come in the form of loneliness. Oppression can come in the form of discouragement. It can come in the form of anger. It can come in the form of addiction. It can come in the form of sickness and disease. So Jesus was anointed with the Holy Ghost and power, and he did what? He went about doing good and setting people free that were oppressed. The Holy Spirit. Jesus said of the Holy Spirit, he said, it's the Spirit that quickens, but the flesh profits nothing. Yeah. So Jesus understood, you know what, guys? It's the Spirit that makes the difference. He made sure that, you know, if you've seen me, you've seen the Father. He made sure that he knew, he goes, you know, without the Father, I can of my own self do nothing. He made sure that he did not get the credit for what he was doing. He understood that there was someone greater than him on the inside of him doing what he was doing. And it was the Holy Spirit. It was the Father working in him and through him. But how did he do it? Through the work of the Holy Spirit. Jesus understood it's the Spirit that quickens. Well, what does the word quicken mean? It means produces life. Makes alive. It's the Spirit that makes alive. It's the Spirit quickens, but the flesh profits nothing.
Yeah, that's right.
The Spirit makes alive. I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit makes the difference.
Yeah.
He is the difference maker.
That's right. Amen.
I'm telling you, if you hook up with the Holy Ghost,
come on.
If you hook up with the Holy Ghost,
come on.
And you choose to walk with the Holy Ghost,
that's right.
He will lead you into all truth.
Yeah.
He will equip your life. He will empower your life.
Yeah.
He will bring out of things in you you never thought were in you.
That's right.
Because it's what he does.
Yeah.
It's who he is.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit. It's an empowerment from heaven.
Amen.
To free you, to equip you, and to change your life. Take the Holy Spirit sent to bring you to a place of victory over all the works of the enemy.
Yeah.
Let's look at Isaiah chapter 59 here. Isaiah chapter 59, verse 19. It says, "So shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and his glory from the rising of the sun. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him."
That's right. Come on.
Who lifts up a standard? The Spirit of the Lord.
That's right.
So when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord lifts up a standard. Now, there is no punctuation in the Hebrew language, and so there are different ways how the translator put this. Now, you can look at it two ways. You could look at it like this. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord lifts up a standard against him. Or you could look at it like this. When the enemy comes in, comma, like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord lifts up a standard against him. But you know what? Either way you look at it, still the answer is always the same, that we win. It doesn't matter if you look at the enemy as a flood or you look at the Spirit of the Lord as a flood. It doesn't matter which way you look at it, we win. And so instead of talking about which one's a flood, just know that the Spirit of God wins. It's the Spirit of God that wins. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord lifts up a stand. See, what does the enemy do? He comes in to bring what? Oppression. But what we see, the Spirit of God is what lifts up a standard against him. Against him who? The enemy. The word lift up a standard is actually not several Hebrew words. It's actually one Hebrew word, and it means to put to flight. If you look that up in any concordance, the word lift up a standard is actually all one word, and it means to put to flight, or it also can mean to cause to disappear. So when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord causes the enemy to disappear. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord causes the enemy to leave. The Spirit of the Lord is the answer to your oppression.
That's right. Amen. Amen.
He's the answer to your oppression. He's the answer to whatever you're experiencing, whatever heavy load that you're experiencing right now. The Holy Spirit is the answer. Amen. Jesus is the answer. The Holy Spirit is the answer.
Yes,
hallelujah. The Holy Spirit. He destroys the works of the enemy.
Come on, that's right.
When the enemies come in, the Spirit of the Lord lifts up a standard.
That's right. Amen.
See, the thing is, when the enemy comes in, what we have to ask ourselves is, what's coming out of my mouth? What's reigning in my thoughts? When the enemy comes in like a flood. See, that's the moment as believers we should just yield to the Holy Spirit and say, I can't do this in my own strength. I can't do this in my own ability. I don't have the ability to do this in my own self, but Father, I give this to you. Because it's the Spirit of God. It's not Justin that causes the enemy to flee. It's not you that brings change to the situation. It is the Spirit of the Lord. We need to stop doing His job. We need to stop doing His job. Our only job is to believe. You'll never be able to save yourself, free yourself, or heal yourself. It's the Holy Spirit. And no matter what storm you might go through, you need to realize the Holy Spirit is with you every step of the way.
Amen.
You realize that between the Spirit of God and the Word of God, you have everything in you to be victorious.
That's right.
The Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
You have everything in you to be victorious.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The year of the breaking loose is the year of the great breaking loose is all about yielding to His Word and yielding to the Holy Spirit that's on the inside of you, because He is what brings it to. He's the one that brings it to pass. Hallelujah. When the enemy comes in, the Spirit of the Lord lifts up a standard against him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Dr. Savelle last week, man, what an awesome message last week. Man, wasn't that an awesome message? Powerful message. What did he talk to us about? He talked about living according to the world's normal or living according to God's normal. See, we need to stop living according to the world's normal.
That's right. Come on.
We're not called to live according to the world's normal. We're called to live filled with the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
We're called to live filled with the Spirit of God. Thank you, Father. Let's go to John chapter 3. The Spirit of God is the difference maker. Causes us to live different. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. The Holy Spirit. Verse 5, Jesus is talking to Nicodemus here. It says, Jesus answered, I assure you most solemnly, I tell you, unless a man is born of water and even the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Now, what is born of the flesh is flesh, and of the physical is physical. I'm reading the Amplified. And what is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not, do not be surprised or astonished at my telling you, you must all be born anew from above. What does he tell him? You must be born anew from above. You must be born from above. The word of born again, just the original translation of that is you need to be born from above. Is really what's the saying. So Jesus is saying, Nicodemus, you know what? You need to live differently. You're basing everything on physical. You need to come to a place where you understand that physical can only produce physical. But you have to understand that it's the spiritual that can produce spiritual. And he was telling them, you need to understand this, that you all must be born from above.
Yes.
Now, if someone asks you where you're from, what do you tell them? Easton, Maryland. Easton Memorial Hospital. September 23rd of 1973. But here he says we need to be born from above. Where are you from? From above.
Come on.
I'm from above. Now, if someone in the world asks you that, don't tell them that, please. My pastor told me I'm from above, brother. They're like, okay, I'll go over here. But Jesus, you need to understand something, Nicodemus. You don't have to base your life or your future on your past or anything physical. You need to understand it's going to be based upon the Spirit of God. Verse 8 says, the wind blows where it wills, and though you hear its sound, yet you neither know where it comes from or where it's going. So it is with everyone that is born of the Spirit. Now let's look at John 3, chapter 3, verse 31. Jesus is saying here, it says, he that comes from above is above all. Actually, it's John the Baptist speaking. He that comes from above is above all. He that is of the earth is earthly and speaks of the earth. He that comes from heaven is above all. Verse 34, for he whom God has sent speaks the words of God, for God giveth not the Spirit by measure unto him. The Amplified says in verse 34, for since he whom God has sent speaks the words of God, proclaims God's own message, God does not give him his Spirit sparingly or by measure, but boundless is the gift God makes of His Spirit. Meaning when God gives His Spirit, He gives it without measure. When God pours something out by His Spirit, it is without limitation. Now, so John the Baptist is now talking of Jesus was talking to Nicodemus, said, you must be from above. Then John the Baptist is talking about Jesus and says, he that comes from above is above all. He that's of the earth just speaks of the earth, but he that's from above speaks of the things of heaven. Now let's go to chapter 8. I'm going somewhere, so just stay with me, all right? John chapter 8, verse 23. And he said unto him, you are from beneath, and I am from above. You are of this world, and I'm not of this world. So what I want to establish here is I want you to understand is that we need to live different than the rest of the world.
Right.
Jesus didn't come to live like the world. He came to live like he was from above. He came to live differently.
That's right.
And the Holy Spirit was sent so we could live differently. differently.
Come on.
Let's go to Acts chapter 1. This will all come together. Acts chapter 1. The Holy Spirit is the difference maker. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 1, verse 4. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but they should wait for the promise of the Father, which saith, you have heard of me. For John truly baptizes with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days from now. When they therefore were come together, they asked him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom of Israel? Verse 7, and he said to them, it is not for you to know the times of the season which the Father had put in his own power. Verse 8, but you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you.
Come on.
The Holy Spirit was to come upon them so they could live differently. Not so they would stay the same. And I want to encourage every single one of us in here that are born again believers. Yeah. We're not called to live like the rest of the world.
Right. Right. Amen. Come on.
Only a couple amens on that one. Jesus said, when you're born from above by the Spirit, you'll speak differently.
Yeah.
You'll live differently.
Yes.
You'll talk differently. Yeah. You'll walk differently. You'll carry yourself differently. You'll respond differently. We're not like the rest of the world. And as much as I hate to see it, more and more it seems like that people become more and more like the world instead of becoming more and more like heaven. Now, I'm not talking about religious pictures or religious images. I'm talking about attitude. I'm talking about the heart of God. I'm talking about the heart of the Father. And bringing in the nature of rebellion into the church. There's a difference. But what I want us to see here is that we are to be different. It says, go there until you are filled with the Holy Spirit. And that'll be a spirit of, it'll be a power. Now over this last week, Annette and I were out of town and just praying over things. And I kept hearing the statement on the inside of me. And he kept saying, the Holy Spirit, being filled with the Holy Spirit, being filled with the Holy Spirit. He kept talking to me about being filled with the Holy Spirit, being filled and overflowing with the Holy Spirit. And he kept speaking to me and showing me things. And I was looking at Jesus and I was looking at the disciples and I was seeing, okay, what was the characteristics of them being filled with the Holy Spirit? And he told me three things. And he said these three things were the predominant characteristics of the disciples and Jesus when they were filled with the Holy Spirit. The first thing he said was power. The second thing he said was divine wisdom. And the third thing he said was a holy boldness. Amen. He said, if you look at the disciples and you look at Jesus, they carried these three things, a power, a wisdom, and a boldness. Amen. The power gave them the ability to do what God had called them to do. The wisdom gave them the direction to get it done, and the boldness gave them the confidence to get it done. And it was these three things that when they were filled with the Holy Spirit that dropped down on the inside of them that caused them to fulfill their destiny. The power of God, the wisdom of God, and the boldness to get it done. Now, I don't have time to deal with wisdom this morning or deal with boldness this morning, but I want to talk about this word power. Because power, what is power? Power changes things. When I came in here this morning, no one else was in here, all the lights were off, and I flicked the lights on. What happened? I brought power to the light. And when I brought power to the light, it changed the atmosphere of this room.
Come on, that's right.
So power in itself is a force that changes things. It's an ability that changes things. And as I got praying about this power and thinking about this power, immediately we can get caught up in just the moment of when power happens, or say an explosion, well, that was powerful, or a lightning bolt, that was powerful, and you see the effects of that power and you see what it's produced. But the Lord kept speaking to me about something else. He said, don't look at the external result of power.
Come on.
I was like, what do you mean? He said, I want you to look at the internal workings of power.
Wow.
I was like, what does that mean? I was like, what do you mean the internal workings of power? And he started talking to me about lightning. And as I started researching lightning and what lightning is, you know, when you see lightning is powerful, right? You know what a stream of lightning is? Over 20,000 degrees Celsius. A bolt of lightning, one bolt of light, 20,000 degrees Celsius. But lightning just doesn't just happen. There has to be elements that work together to produce the bolt of lightning. In order for you to have lightning, you need to have water and you need to have ice. And when the two things are compressed together with warm air flowing up and gravity pushing it down, it compresses the particles together and they create friction. It's like if you take a balloon and you blow a balloon up and you rub that balloon, what happens? Friction happens, and all of a sudden you put it in your hair, it stands straight up.
Come on.
So it's the same thing with lightning. When the water and the ice rub together because of the pressure of the gravity coming down and the warm air coming out, it has nowhere else to go, and it finds a positive charge goes one way and a negative charge goes down. And so there you have lightning. So it's not just lightning, but it's elements that produce lightning. It's not just fire. Fire can be powerful. But fire is not a thing. Fire is actually an event. Fire is a result of when three different chemicals have to be present. You have to have a heat, you have to have fuel, and you have to have oxygen. So anytime you take one of those things out, the fire ceases to be. So you don't have the power of what fire can do unless you have the right elements.
That's right. Come on.
That's good.
Come on.
So what is this power that Jesus walked in? What is this power that the disciples walked in? Let's go to Galatians chapter 5. Galatians chapter 5. Because this is something that we need to receive, but this is also something that we have to give out. Why? Because he told the disciples, I want you to go and you'll be filled with the Holy Spirit and you'll be clothed with what? Power. So let's look at Galatians chapter 5. So when Jesus was filled with the Spirit, it wasn't just filled with a thing called power. But what was the power? Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Verse 13. For brethren, you have been called into liberty. Only use not your liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. For all the law is fulfilled in one word, even in this, that thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. But if you bite and devour one another, take heed that you be not consumed by one another. This I say then, walk in the Spirit, and you will do what? Not fulfill the lusts of the flesh. For the flesh lusts against the Spirit, meaning the flesh is totally opposed to the things of the Spirit. Remember, we're called to be different. We're called to live different. We're called to act different. Why? Because we're born from above. For the flesh is against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh, and these are contrary to one another, so that you cannot do these things that you would. But if you were led of the Spirit, you were not under the law. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulation, wrath, strife, sedition, heresies, envies, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and the such the like, of the which I tell you before, as I have told you in times past, that they do not such things shall inherit the kingdom of God. Meaning, if you're doing things according to the way the world does them, you're not going to receive the results of what the kingdom can produce. Meaning, you could be a said a sinner's prayer and been born again, but yet going out living the way you want to. And if you the way you do that, you're not going to walk in what the kingdom wants to produce in your life. Verse 22, but the fruit of the Spirit. The fruit of the Spirit. The results of the Spirit. The outflow of what the Spirit provides. Are what? Love. Thank you, Father. Peace. Joy. Long-suffering. Gentleness. Goodness. Faith. Meekness. Temperance. Against such there is no law. So when it talks about being filled with the Spirit and power, and we talk about power, it's not just this flash of lightning, but what makes up that power? It is love. What Jesus went about doing good. It said there were times when Jesus was what moved with compassion. You see, that was the fruit of the Spirit. The being filled with the Spirit is not being filled with goosebumps. It's not being filled with some sort of ability that makes you fall on the ground. Being filled with the Spirit is being filled with love. It's about being filled with joy. It's about being filled with peace. It's about being filled with long-suffering. It's about being filled with temperance. It's about being filled with goodness. It's about being filled with gentleness. You see, these are the elements that produce the external manifestations of power. It was the love of God and the peace of God and the joy of God, the long-suffering, the gentleness, the goodness, that when Jesus laid hands on someone, they were healed. It was the elements that produced the power. Jesus was moved with compassion. What is joy? Joy, it says what is our strength. See, there is a strength quality to joy. And according to John chapter 16, it's not a joy that the world gives. The world can't produce this joy. Right. What about peace? Jesus said, my peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. What? Not as the world gives. This is a supernatural peace. This is a supernatural love. This is a supernatural joy. This is a supernatural long-suffering. This is a supernatural temperance. What's temperance? Temperance is the ability to control your passions. Ability to control your cravings. If you keep giving into your flesh, it's because you're not filled with a spirit enough to where temperance is involved. If people will say, well, what about that pastor and that wife? They were on the worship. She was on the worship team, and he was this, and they were both filled with the Spirit, and they ran off together. They were filled with the Spirit. Not that day. Not that day. Being filled with the Spirit isn't. Hey, I pray in tongues. And I'm gonna get into the gift of tongues here. I don't know if it's next week or what, but and talk about that, because it's a powerful gift that we've been given and a right that we have as believers. Amen. But being filled with the Spirit. People say, well, they were filled with the Spirit. Well, the thing is, it might not have been that day. Maybe they were filled another day, but not that day. If you're angry all the time, And you can't seem to love other people, you need to get filled with the Spirit. Yes. Peace. It's not from this world. It is supernatural. Yeah. Faith. What is faith? Faith moves mountains. Yeah. Yes. What is long-suffering? It's patience. What's goodness? What did God say? He goes, I'll let you see my backside and I'll let you see my goodness. The goodness of God is the glory of God. What is gentleness? David said, thy gentleness has made me great. What is meekness? It's humility. It's perfect power and perfect control. You see, and when you see these elements and they work together, what happens is they produce a power in your life. The fruit of the Spirit. When we start operating with the fruit of the Spirit, power will be released in our lives. Tell you, when you love supernaturally, yeah. and you're moved with compassion. I'm telling you, when you're meek and you humble yourself under the Word of God, when you have this joy that's on the inside of you and the world doesn't understand why you're happy and you shouldn't be happy, it produces a power. This is what caused Jesus to do what he did. He was filled with the Holy Spirit, but the Holy Spirit isn't it. He's a person. And he provides a supernatural fruits of the Spirit. And he provides what? The gifts of the Spirit. Amen. The working of miracles. Love, joy, peace. Now, I wrote it out this way. Jesus was moved with compassion. And as he was, he released peace. He was strengthened by joy. He had an unshakable faith in his Father. He was temperate in all things. He refused to be moved in adversity, but made a choice to operate with gentleness while revealing God's goodness to the world. Let me read that again. Jesus was moved with compassion, and he released peace. He was strengthened by joy. He had an unshakable faith in his Father. He was temperate in all things. He refused to be moved in adversity, but made a choice to operate with gentleness while revealing God's goodness to the world. All the fruit of the Spirit, they're not some natural passive things, but they're spiritual forces that, when yielded to and cultivated, bring victorious living. When we yield to the fruit of the Spirit and we cultivate the fruit of the Spirit, it brings forth victorious living. So when the enemy comes in like a flood, it's the Spirit of God that lifts up a standard. But what does the Spirit bring? Love, joy, peace, patience. You know, this ministry that we're a part of, Dr. Sell's ministry, has been known for making winners in life. Not quitting, not giving up. But not quitting and not giving up is not just some sort of mental thing that you decide up here, but it's a fruit of the Holy Spirit that you choose to tap into. Being filled with the Spirit is not saying, hey, so we can say we're charismatic. We're a Spirit-filled church. No, it's so we can radiate, so we can be filled with, and we can release love. So we can release joy, so we can release peace, we can release patience, we can release faith, we can release goodness, we can release gentleness, and we can release meekness. I'm telling you, that is being filled with the Spirit. And when we release those things, it produces power, not just in our lives, but it will produce power in our homes. It will produce power in our loved ones. It will produce power when we're at work. It will produce power everywhere we go. And the Lord just really ministered. He said, Justin, yeah, you can look at the power of the Holy Spirit as doing something like, yeah, dividing a Red Sea and things like that. But at the same time, you have to understand that it's the fruit of the Spirit. And what, even that dividing the Red Sea, what did Moses have to have? Faith to raise the rod. The Apostle Paul, when he was thrown in jail, and he was in the Philippian jail, one of the worst jails in history, and he was in the lower parts of the prison, but yet he writes back to the church of Philippi and he says, rejoice in the Lord. And again, I say, rejoice. What will cause a man to say, rejoice in the Lord? And again, I say, rejoice, when you're beaten, you're bruised, and you're laying in pretty much sewage. Yeah. Come on. Yeah, Tom, he's not of this world.
Come on.
Not of this world. We're to live from above. How do we live from above? By being filled with the Spirit. What is being filled with the Spirit? We're full of love. We're full of joy. We're full of peace. We're full of long-suffering. Hallelujah. We need to be filled. Filled with the Spirit. Filled with the fruit of the Spirit. That's how Jesus released power. I could show you multiple scriptures how it uses these different words and how it brought about supernatural outcomes. Hallelujah. The Apostle Paul in Ephesians 6, having done all to stand therefore. That's a man that's filled with the Spirit.
That's right.
Long-suffering, constant. I'm not moving. I'm not budging. I'm not moving from. This is who I am. I'm filled with God. It doesn't matter what the enemy throws at me. It doesn't matter what the enemy tries to put in me. I'm filled with love. I'm filled with joy. Hallelujah. That's why Ephesians 5 tells us, it says that we need to be being filled with the Spirit. This needs to be a continual thing that we do in our lives. Being filled with the Spirit. Hallelujah. Let's go back to Acts chapter 1. Acts chapter 1. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We don't live according to this world, but we live from above. Amen. Filled with the Spirit. Let's look at verse 8 again. But you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and the uttermost parts of the earth. You shall be witnesses unto me. So this power is to cause us to be witnesses. What is a witness? A witness influences something. An influence, a witness gives proof of something. A witness testifies to something. It said, so when you are filled with the Holy Spirit, you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come. I mean, you're going to receive this power, but this power is to do something. It's to cause you to be a witness.
That's right. Come on.
To be a witness unto Him, not a witness for Him. There's a difference. That you'll be a witness unto Him. If I'm just a witness for Him, I talk about what he did and what He can do. If I'm a witness for Him. But if I'm a witness unto Him, that means I can do the same things He did.
That's right. Come on.
I don't think some of you got that. We are called to be witnesses unto Him, not witnesses for Him. If I'm just a witness for Him, then I just talk about what He did and what He can do. But when I'm a witness unto Him, then I can do the same things He did.
That's right.
So we are filled with the Holy Ghost and we've been given power so we can do what He did. Witnesses. We are called to be filled with the Holy Ghost and we are called to be filled with that power. But what is that power? It's love. It's joy. It's peace. Hallelujah. It's long-suffering, meekness, gentleness, goodness. That is power.
That's right.
It is not... You know, because I've heard messages talked about the fruit of the Spirit, and I've heard good messages, but sometimes they limit the fruit of the Spirit to some sort of passive attitude. No, I'm telling you, it is what makes God God.
Right.
It's the fruit of the Spirit. What is the fruit of an apple tree? Apples. So what is the fruit of God? It is love, it is joy, it is peace, it is patience, it's long-suffering. Meaning, so as Jesus operated, we need to operate. And how are we going to operate like Jesus operated? By being filled with the Spirit. And being filled with the Spirit isn't just saying, hey, oh, I got goosebumps today. No, I'm telling you, your attitude changed. You walk different, you talk different, you live different. It's no big deal to wait in traffic. It's no big deal to wait till the promise comes to pass. It's not a big deal. Why? Because you have long suffering. It's not a big deal to control your body or control your appetite. Why? Because you have temper. It's not a big deal. Why? Because you're operating in the fruit of the Spirit. As you operate in the fruit of the Spirit, you're releasing power in your life.
Come on. That's right.
Hallelujah.
That's right.
Hallelujah. I know this might be a little deep this morning. Hallelujah. And sometimes when the Lord has me preach things, I'm like, I haven't heard anybody else preach this. He said, you be obedient.
Come on, there you go.
Filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. If this church is a Holy Ghost filled church, then we need to have more love than anywhere else. If we're a Holy Ghost church, then we need to have more joy than anywhere else. If we're a Holy Ghost church, we need to have more peace than any other church. If we are a Holy Ghost church, That means that we need to be operating alongside. If we're a Holy Ghost church, we need to have meekness in this place. If we're a Holy Ghost church, we need to be operating in gentleness. If we're a Holy Ghost church, hallelujah. Don't tell me you're filled with the Holy Ghost, but yet gossip about other people. I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit changes your ability to live naturally. And the church hasn't changed for the most part because it's filled with the Holy Spirit but not overflowing with the Holy Spirit. Might be filled with the Holy Spirit but not filled with what the fruit of the Spirit wants to provide.
Yes, sir. That's right.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Be witnesses. How are we going to influence the world? Being filled with the Holy Spirit. But it's what the Holy Spirit produces.
Yes.
It's power.
Yes.
But how is power produced? Love, joy, peace, patience.
Come on.
All those things. God is looking for people that are filled with the Holy Ghost.
Yes. Come on.
Read two verses and we'll close. Go to Acts chapter 6. God is looking for people that are filled with the Holy Ghost. Now, Corinthians lays out a great picture. You know, he says that, you know, you talk of tongues of angels, but yet if you're out, if you don't have love, what are you? You see people healed, or you cast out demons, but you have, what are you? So that lets me know there's more to this than just the external manifestations of something happen. It's about what's happening internally. And what's happening internally, the fruit of the Spirit growing and building, will release the external manifestations. Acts chapter 6, verse 5. Hallelujah. And the saying pleased the whole multitude, and they chose Stephen. Hallelujah. I need to read verse 2. Then the 12 called the multitude of the disciples unto them and said, it is not reason that we should leave the word of God and serve tables. Wherefore, brethren, look ye out among you 7 men of honest report, full of the Holy Ghost and wisdom, whom we may appoint over this business. But we will give ourselves continue to prayer and to the ministry of the word. And the saying pleased the whole multitude, and they chose Stephen, a man full of faith and of the Holy Ghost, and Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas, and a proselyte of Antioch, whom they set before the apostles. And when they had prayed, they laid their hands on them. And the word of God increased, and number of the disciples multiplied in Jerusalem greatly, and a great company of the priests were obedient. And Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles among the people.
Come on.
So here you had these disciples. They were looking for someone that was filled with the Holy Ghost. God is looking for people that are filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
The disciples were looking for people that were filled with the Holy Ghost. And as they found them and they put in place, what happened? The church multiplied and the church increased.
Yes. Come on.
And what happened? It said Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles.
That's right. Come on.
God is looking for people that are filled with the Holy Ghost.
Yeah. Come on.
I'm telling you, as a church, we're looking for people that are filled with the Holy Ghost.
Come on. Yeah.
Now let's go to Genesis chapter 41. Genesis chapter 41. Verse 37. It says, and the thing was good in the eyes of Pharaoh, in the eyes of all his servants. Verse 38. And Pharaoh said unto his servant, can we find such a one as this? A man in whom the Spirit of God is. Now you see someone that is not a Christian. You see Pharaoh, which represents the world system. Now you see someone in the world looking for someone, saying, can anyone else find someone that's like this man? Can anybody find someone that's like him? Can a man whom the Spirit... Can we find... Hey, guys, can you find anyone else that's like Joseph? Can you find anyone else that's like him in whom the Spirit of God is? And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, "For as much as God has shown thee all this, there is none so discreet and wise as you are." Here Pharaoh was looking for other people that were like this man that was filled with the Spirit. God is looking for people that are filled with the Spirit. The church is looking for people that are filled with the Spirit. I'm telling you, the world is looking for people that are filled with the Spirit. They might not know it, but they're looking for it. They might not be able to put their hand on it, their finger on it, but they're looking for it. Here, Joseph, a man that was thrown in prison, but yet the Spirit of God still shined through. Man, what a Joseph, a man, I don't have time to go into his life. A man of patience. A man that honored. A man that was meek. A man that did great things. And here, Pharaoh said, "Can anyone else find me a man like him?" Your bosses need to be saying that about you. Your family needs to be saying that about you. Your friends need to be saying, there's something different about you. I tell you, because the Spirit of God is what makes the difference. We're not called to live according to our natural selves, but we're called to live on a whole different level. And the only way to live on a whole other level is being filled with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for your word this morning. We thank you for the faithfulness to your word. Father, I thank you, Lord, that we are a church, Father, that is filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We are filled with the Holy Spirit. Everybody stand on your feet. A church that's filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are a church that's filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We are a people that's filled with the Holy Spirit. Father, I thank you that we are a church that's overflowing in love, overflowing in joy, overflowing in peace, overflowing in meekness, overflowing in gentleness, overflowing in goodness. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Filled with the Holy Spirit. Filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Filled with the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Just lift your hands. Oh, Father, we thank you. We receive the filling of the Holy Spirit to change us from the inside out. That's what the Holy Spirit is all about. It's about changing us from the inside out. Our whole lives, Father, we've been living from the outside in. What Galatians is talking about. You live and walk after the flesh. You've been living based on the outside in. Thank you for the Holy Spirit, Father. So we can live from the inside out. Filled with peace. Filled with joy. Hallelujah. 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 Filled. Across this room this morning, I just declare fill a revelation of the fruit of the Spirit, a revelation of the fruit of the Spirit, a revelation of love, a revelation of joy, a revelation of peace. First of all, you have to receive the fruit of the Spirit for yourself. You need to receive the fruit of the Spirit. You need to receive the love of God, the peace of God, the joy of God, the strength of God, the goodness of God, the faith of God. Hallelujah. Fill. Hallelujah. Filled with the Holy Spirit. Filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Filled. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord lifts up a standard. Filled. filled to live different, filled to be different, filled to respond different, filled to talk different. Hallelujah. Filled. Filled with so much faith that fear no longer torments you. We have not been given a spirit of fear. Hallelujah. But of power, love, and a sound mind. Hallelujah. 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 Fear, you bow yourself in this place. Fear, you have no right to torment them any longer. Hallelujah. 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 I sense in my heart there's a couple in here that you fear has just gripped your heart concerning cancer. Fear has gripped your heart concerning cancer. Just make your way to the altar right here. Hallelujah. Fear has gripped your heart. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's just a fear on the inside of you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 There's at least two others here. The peace of God, the peace of God, the peace of God to flow through every part of her body. The peace of God. Filled, 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 joy, 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 joy. That's it. Joy, 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 joy. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I just still, two more people that need to be up here. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You're questioning yourself whether that's me or not. If you're questioning, it's you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. If you've been oppressed, if you've been oppressed, just make your way to the altar right now. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. There's just been a heaviness, hallelujah, on you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. When you come up, I don't want you to pray, I just want you to receive. Eleda ashtende kotolo no mose. It's not time for you to leave. It's not time for you to throw in the towel. It's not time for you to give up. It's not time. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, don't, that's broken in Jesus' name. Oh, taste it edible stalanamaya. Send a letter more. Fresh wind in you. Fresh wind through you. Fresh wind, they sticky and the Lord of Mosa. Eso, Lord of Namonde. Ezendelede Mondede. And tell it, it's trying to keep you out. It's trying to keep you out. And they stick lede mandelene moshendelene mundelede de bosi. Hallelujah. Don't let the enemy keep you away from the house of God. Yeah, I know it can be tiring. I know, yeah, yeah, with the kid, yeah, it's tiring. Yeah, yeah, but you need to, because this is going to change your life forever. Because there's great things in you and there's great things for you. So be filled, be filled, be filled, be filled, be filled. Hallelujah. In the same rate this discouragement has come, will be the same heaviness that joy will come. It's time to laugh. It's time to laugh. It's time to laugh. It's time to laugh. Yeah, yeah, just let it go. Just let it go. Hallelujah. Yeah, no more sondo. Ha, ha, ha. Hey, 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 hey. Ooh, hey, 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 hey. Oh, hey, 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 oh, hey, 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 hey. Oh, I'm laughing because the enemy's defeated. I'm laughing because he doesn't win. I'm laughing because the enemy is leaving right now. He has to go. He has to go. He has to go. Oh, hey, oh, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, lende sticky and la monde, a little more sender in the east to see. Oh, zongo del enemaya. Jesus was filled with grace and truth. Jesus was filled with grace and truth. And there was a time that he spoke to the fig tree, and there was a time that he talked about speaking to a mountain, and there was a time that he spoke to the storm. And so right now I say, peace be still in the name of Jesus. Oh, Randeshta. Oh, filled, 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 filled. Oh, hallelujah. A supernatural peace. Supernatural peace. 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 Oh, hallelujah. Oh. Oh, hallelujah. The shackles are taken off. No more. There is. Oh, no more. 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 His yoke is easy, his burden is light. His yoke is easy, his burden is light. His yoke is easy, his burden is light. Filled, 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 filled. Ah, le monde de l'ébauche, le côté de l'ébauche. Oh, chien de l'édémacoso. Oh, j'en gonde de l'édémacoso. Filled, 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 filled. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Annette. Annette, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Rest, rest in me. Oh, my God. Your life is so much more than where you've been. Oh, God. Where the enemy is trying to use. I'm just going to just follow to my heart. The things that have marked you, whether it be through abuse or through neglect, can mark you no longer. The enemy's plans come to nothing in you. You are the apple of my eye. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. There's some in here that you're believing for a mate. You're believing to be married. You're believing for a relationship. And it seems to just weigh on you. The enemy just weighs on your mind about it. You, his yoke is easy, his burden is light. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If that's you, just slip your hand where you are. There's nothing to be ashamed of or anything like that. If you see someone with their hand up, just place your hand on them and pray for them. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I thank you for those that are single in this place, Father. I thank you, Lord, that they're filled with love. They're filled with peace. They're filled with joy, long-suffering, filled with patience, filled with meekness, filled with faith, filled with gentleness, and filled with goodness. And Father, I thank you for the person that you have in store for them, the desire of their heart. I thank you that they are filled with love, that they're filled with joy, that they're filled with gentleness, that they're filled with the fruits of the Spirit. I thank you, Father, that you make up for what is lacking. So, Father, I thank you that in this season of singleness, I thank you that you refresh them. I thank you that you revive them, that you build with them and then place them within them a hope and a strength. Hallelujah. That they would be equipped, that they would be ready, that they'd be prepared for the person that you're bringing into their lives, not someone that's empty, not someone that's halfway, but someone that's totally filled with you, totally filled with love, totally filled with purpose, totally filled with destiny, that they would not get ahead of you, but they would have rest, knowing that you're directing them and guiding them, that you would strengthen them in this season of singleness. And prepare them for that next season. Oh, Father, I just thank you for moving in this place today, manifesting yourself in this place today. Hallelujah, we thank you. Oh, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, you're faithful. You're faithful, you're faithful, you're faithful. Oh, thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Oh, God is good. Hallelujah. God is faithful. Just say this with me. Fill me up every day with what I need. Fill me up to overflow with love, with joy, with peace, and with all the fruits of the Spirit.
And I will be victorious
in my own life.
And I'll help someone
else
be victorious
in theirs.
In Jesus' name.
Give him a shout of praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Rick, you can come on, come up,
and
you
go ahead and be
seated. We're going to receive
this morning's tithes and
offerings.
Rick
will receive the offering in
just a moment,
but just
want to
encourage everyone
tonight
at 6 o'clock,
we'll
have worship night.
I don't
want to miss it.
I'm telling
you,
it'll
be a powerful time
where
we just
come together,
where we just
worship God,
and we
just allow
the Holy Spirit
to move.
I encourage
you
to be
here
at
6
o'clock, and
we'd love
to see you then.
Rick?
Hallelujah.
Praise
the
Lord.
Amen.
Reminded me
of a song,
Fill My
Cup,
Lord.
I lift
it up,
Lord.
And
then
Psalms 23,
My
cup runneth
over.
Surely
goodness and
mercy
shall follow
me all
the days
of my life.
And
I only
had
two
scriptures
that
I had
for offering,
and one
was
Hebrews
11,
chapter
11, verse
1.
It says,
Now
faith
is
a substance
of things
hoped for,
the
evidence
of things
not
yet seen.
And
then
Romans
chapter
5, verse
5,
which
Pastor
Justin
quoted
numerous
times
during the
service
today.
But
hope,
the first part
of that
ties
into
Hebrews
chapter 11.
Hope
maketh
not
ashamed.
Hope
maketh
not
ashamed,
because
the love
of God
is shed
abroad in
our hearts
by
the
Holy
Ghost.
Amen.
You know,
and
what
you
and I
have
to
continuously
walk in,
faith
is always
in operation.
And
faith,
it takes faith
to
walk out what
the
Holy Spirit
is
speaking
to
you
and
through you
in
your
spirit
man.
And
as you
and
I
continuously,
in
Jude
verse
20,
it says,
as
we pray
in
the
Holy
Spirit,
we
build
ourselves
up in
the
most
holy
faith.
So
when
you're
looking
at
your
finances,
hope
maketh
not
ashamed.
Amen.
For
the
love
of God
is shed
abroad in
our hearts
by the
Holy
Spirit.
As
we
continue
to
abide
in the Word
and the Word
abides
in
us,
we're
going to
bear
the
fruit
of
the
Holy Spirit
that
lives
on the
inside
of us.
And
the
Holy
Spirit
is
our
quickener.
He's
our
helper.
He's
our
strengthener.
He's
our standby.
He's
our
advocate
to
help us
to
produce
what's
on
the
inside
of us.
Amen.
And
you got
to
understand,
God
loves
me.
Amen.
Why do
we
give?
Because
God
loves
me.
Why
do we
want to
give?
Because
God
loves
me.
Amen.
How
do
we
get
stirred up
about
that?
We
stay stirred
up
by
the
Holy Spirit
because
God
loves
me.
Amen.
I do what I do.
You
came here this
morning
because
you
know what? You
had
a revelation
that
God
loves
me.
God
loves
me.
God
has
something
for
me.
God
is a good
God.
You've
got
to
constantly
stir
yourselves
up
about
how
much
God
loves
you.
And
we
don't give
because
we have
to.
That's
not
why
we
give.
Pastor
Justin
ministered
an amazing
short
message
on
who
we
are
as
a church
last
Sunday
during
the
tithes and
offerings,
where
tithes and
offerings
are
concerned.
It's
not
a debt
we
sow.
We're
not
trying.
We
sow
because
God
loves us.
God
loves us.
Say,
God
loves
me.
Say,
God
loves
me.
God
loves
me.
Hope,
you
got to
see this.
Hope
is not
making
this,
it's not
going to
make
you
ashamed.
God
loves
me.
God
loves
me.
You
and
I have
an opportunity
to
give back
to God
this
morning.
But
you got to
stir
that
up on
you.
God
loves
me.
Well,
you
don't
have
to
give
this
morning.
You
don't
have
to.
But
man,
when
you
understand
how
much
God
loves
you,
when
that
love
is being
built
up on
the
inside
of you,
and
you
have
a
revelation
of that
love
that's
on
the
inside
of you,
and
that
love
that
surrounds
you,
it's
so
easy
for you.
Man,
God,
I
love you.
I
just
want
to sow
this back
into
you, God.
Thank
you,
God,
for
being
so
good
to me.
Thank
you,
God,
for
giving
me
that peace
that
surpasses
all
understanding.
Thank
you,
God,
for helping
me
to
be kind.
Thank
you,
Lord,
that your
love
is being
shed
abroad in
my
heart by
your
Spirit,
because
I didn't
know
what love
was
until
I
had you
on the
inside of
me,
and
your
Spirit
lives
on
the
inside
of
me.
And
I give
because
I love
you,
Lord.
Thank
you
for
loving
me.
Amen? Amen.
Amen.
If you're giving
by
way
of
internet,
if you're watching
live stream
right
now,
God
loves
you,
and we
love
you. We'll pray with you, believe with you. There's a give button right underneath the screen. If you're watching live right now, if you're watching by YouTube, you can go to our website at heritageoffaith.com, and there'll be some giving instructions for you to give. Amen? We stand in agreement with them always, right, folks? Amen? Well, let's pray over our tithes and our offerings. Say, Father God, thank you for loving me. I love you, Lord. Thank you, God, for being good to me. You're a good God. I love you. Thank you. I give because I want to. Devil, you're bound. You have no part of me. I give out of the abundance of my heart this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Ushers, if you'll receive the tithes and the offerings, that'll be great. Thank you. Isn't that wonderful? We have had an amazing morning, haven't we? Isn't it so good? Get filled up, amen. Are you filled up this morning? Stay filled up, but let your filled up stay overflowing, amen. Don't stop here. There are a lot of things that are going on this week. Pastor Justin just mentioned tonight. Come here. You will be amazed at what a continuation from this morning will take place tonight, and we'll go to another level together. Amen. So you want to be here tonight. Also, this Wednesday night, we'll continue talking about healing, getting overflow. You need that word on the inside of you. It's washing. You're being washed by the water, by the word, where healing is concerned on Wednesday nights right now. We're going to continue that message this Wednesday night. Today, if you auctioned or proposed or made a bid for something out there in the lobby, you can pick that up right outside as you go out the doors. Tanya's going to be at the desk. She'll have your tag there. Hopefully, your bid won, you know, but you're able to check with her. There's also a few more items to be bought that are out there. So as you go out, if you would like to buy some of the desserts that are still there, all this money is going towards the kids' camp this summer, okay? It's going towards kids' camp, all right? So right outside in the bookstore, there are a few more desserts out there if you want to buy some to help support some of our kids. A lot of the kids made these desserts, which is really awesome. Some of their parents did, and some of the ladies in the church pitched in and made some as well. So you want to be a part of that. Also, if you bought a brisket plate, or if you bought a few, we're doing that right now, right after church. As you go out, go to the youth building. They're all ready for you to pick up. If you want to stay here and eat that, there are tables set up in the youth building. You're more than welcome to do that. This was a purchase your tickets in advance. We did prepare about 30 extra just in case. If you'd like to help support the youth, they've got about 30 extra plates that they'll be selling. Please wait a few minutes so that those who have already bought theirs can pick theirs up and then walk in right behind them. That would be super great. Brisket, sausage, beans, potato salad, it's great. So you can pick up your dessert here and then go over there and get your main course, amen? So we're excited about that. Of course, all the brisket plates are going towards our youth that are going to camp. You may have seen some of our youth that exited out of here to make sure that they were helping prepare for the brisket plate. So also this past Wednesday night, how many of you had your car washed in detail by the youth? Well, did they do a good job? They did a great job, didn't they? It was awesome. They did a super awesome job. We're going to do one more week of that this coming Wednesday night. So if you'd like to have your car washed, you can also, in the youth building today, pick up a form and you can tell what they want. If you just want an outside job, or if you want a full detail, or there's little specific things that you can get done with your car over there. But they'll be doing that starting about 6 o'clock on Wednesday night, and we'll go all the way through service time and a little bit after. So be a blessing to our kids. That's also helping send our kids to camp and Guatemala. Some of them are still raising money for that as well. So if you'd be a part of that, that's great. Richard Roberts, if you notice on your chairs this morning when you came in here, you had a card on there for July 3rd. Mark your calendar. And if you know, if you've been believing with one of your family members or a coworker, and they're believing for a healing in their body of some sort, some kind, we're going to have a healing service that Sunday morning right before the Believers Convention starts. Richard Roberts is going to be here and going to be ministering. And he carries a double portion of the anointing that was on his dad's life. And I remember him ministering this year at the Ministers Conference, and it was an amazing time that we had in the presence of the Lord. You don't want to miss this. Mark your calendars, though, and then bring somebody with you that may be believing for healing in their bodies. During the Southwest Believers Convention, we won't have Wednesday night service as well. We're going to be all participating in the Southwest Believers Convention. That's the first week in July. Well, we love you. Can you stand up for just a minute? As we get ready to exit out of here. If you're a first-time visitor, if this is your first time to our church, thank you for coming. We have a gift for you. As you walk out these doors, these double doors, to the right, there's a little room there. There'll be somebody there to greet you, love on you, and we want to sow something into your life. Have you been blessed this morning?
Yes.
Let's pray. Father God, thank you for our time with you. Holy Spirit, thank you for blessing us with your presence this morning in a tangible way. We love you, Lord, with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength. We bless you for giving us this day. In Jesus' name, everybody said,
amen.
Have an awesome day, and we'll see you later.